Hello students, welcome to NS classes. So today we are going to discuss enthalpy for different type of reactions. First of all, we are going to discuss standard enthalpy of combustion. So what is meant by combustion? Combustion means it is a reaction of a substance with oxygen and give out a large amount of energy in the form of light and heat. That is called what? Combustion. So what do you mean by standard enthalpy of combustion? It is an enthalpy change when one mole of a substance it undergo combustion, and here all the reactants and products are in the standard state. That is called standard enthalpy of combustion. Okay, standard state means what? 298 Kelvin and 1 bar pressure. And here what is the symbol for standard enthalpy of combustion? It is represented as this. Delta CH, symbol for standard state. Standard enthalpy of combustion is an exothermic or endothermic reaction. It is an exothermic reaction. Why it is exothermic reaction? Because in combustion reaction, energy is coming out. Okay, when we burn a piece of wood, burning of paper, all these are combustion reaction. So in combustion reaction, energy is coming out from the system. So here the enthalpy change has negative sign. Okay, because here energy is coming out. Okay, that's why standard enthalpy of combustion is negative. So this is an example for combustion reaction, that is when the food that we eat is converted into energy by our body. Okay, our body convert our food into energy. Okay, and this is a combustion reaction. So the food that we contain what? Glucose, carbohydrate, and in the presence of oxygen it converted into us carbon dioxide and water. So this is a combustion reaction. Here the standard enthalpy of combustion is minus 2802.2 kilojoules per mole. So next one is standard enthalpy of atomization. Okay, what is atomization? How a molecule is formed? Okay, molecule is formed when two atoms combine by bonding. And when two atoms combine, what we get? Molecules. Okay, when we break the bond between these atoms, we get what? Atoms. That is called what? Atomization. Okay, for example, hydrogen molecule. Okay, here two hydrogen atoms are there. When we break this bond between these two atoms, that is what called atomization. So here this example is the CH4 giving carbon. Here in methane, carbon and hydrogen are there. And when we break the bond between this carbon and hydrogen, we get carbon and 4 hydrogen. So this is what atomization. Then what is standard enthalpy of atomization? It is the enthalpy change on breaking one mole of a bond completely to obtain atoms in the gaseous phase. Okay, that is what standard enthalpy of atomization. Okay, it is an enthalpy change when one mole of a bond, we here try to break the bond between this atom. So it is an enthalpy change on breaking one mole of a bond completely to obtain atoms in the gaseous phase. Here one important thing is that here the atoms are in the gaseous phase. Okay, that this is what standard enthalpy of atomization, and it is represented as delta A H minus. Is this reaction is endothermic or exothermic? This reaction is endothermic. Why? Because here for breaking this bond between this atom, energy is needed. Okay, here energy is absorbed by the system. So the standard enthalpy of atomization is what? It is positive. That means it is endothermic reaction. So we already discussed what is standard enthalpy of atomization. Now we are going to see two cases. Okay, for diatomic molecules and polyatomic molecules. So in case of diatomic molecules, diatomic molecule means what? Molecule which contain two atoms. Di means what? Two. Okay, so molecule which contain two atoms. Example, H2O2, all these are H2O2, all these are diatomic molecules. So in case of diatomic molecules, standard enthalpy of atomization, which is equal to what? Bond dissociation enthalpy. So what is bond dissociation enthalpy? It is an enthalpy change when one mole of a covalent bond of a gaseous covalent compound is broken. In a diatomic molecule, to break the bond between these two atoms, energy is required, and this enthalpy changes occur in this reaction, and it is called what? Bond dissociation enthalpy. Here we can see hydrogen H2, which is a diatomic molecule, and bond between these two hydrogen atom giving two hydrogen atoms in the gaseous phase. Okay, it is important to note that all these atoms are in the gaseous state. And here we can see the bond dissociation enthalpy, which is equal to what? 435.0 kilojoules per mole. This is the case of diatomic molecule. So when we come to polyatomic molecules, the things are different. Here the standard enthalpy of atomization, which is equal to mean bond enthalpy. The polyatomic molecules means more than two atoms are there in polyatomic molecule. Example, methane. So in methane there are four CH bonds are there. To break all these four bonds, the energy required to break all these four bonds are different. So now we are thinking why they are different, because they are looking same. Okay, these CH, all four CH bonds are looking same, but the energy required to break all these four CH bonds are different. Because if you want to break this first bond, okay, this one is first bond, and the energy required to break this bond is very high, because there is three CH bonds are here, and so they are highly attracted. Carbon, hydrogen, they are highly bonded. Okay, so not to break this bond, we need more energy. So when we move to the second CH bond, okay, now it comes lesser energy to break this bond, because this bond, this CH bond is already broken down, and now only there is two CH bonds are there. So it requires less energy than compared to first. Okay, now we move to the third one. Again less energy is needed. Okay, so the energy required to break all these four bonds are different. So we have to take the average of all these energies. It is called mean bond enthalpy. Okay, for the second CH bond, 439 kilojoules per mole. For breaking the another third CH bond, 452 kilojoules per mole. We have to take the average of all these three bond enthalpies, and we get what standard enthalpy of atomization as 1665 kilojoules per mole, which is the average of all these bond enthalpies. So everyone understand this topic. So please subscribe my channel and stay tuned. Thank you for watching.